We want to solve the given log equation and, if needed, round to four decimal places. Notice how in this equation, the two logarithms don't have the base listed, which means these are common log or log base 10. When we have an equation like this where we have two logarithms, our goal is to combine the logarithms and then write the log equation as an exponential equation to solve for x. So to combine these two logarithms, because we have a sum, we'll use the product property of logarithms given here, where we can combine the two logarithms into a single log if we multiply the number of parts of the logarithms. So common log x plus common log of the quantity x plus 4 is equal to the common log of x times x plus 4. This is still equal to positive 2. Let's go ahead and find this product. So we have log of the quantity x squared plus 4x equals 2. And again, remembering this is common log or log base 10, we can now write this as an exponential equation. So starting with our base and working around the equal sign, we can write the exponential equation. We have 10 raised to the second power must equal the quantity x squared plus 4x. So 10 is the base, 2 is the exponent, and the number is x squared plus 4x. So again, 10 to the second must equal the quantity x squared plus 4x. 10 squared is equal to 100. Notice how we have to solve a quadratic equation. So let's go ahead and set this equal to 0. So we'll subtract 100 on both sides, which will give us 0 equals x squared plus 4x minus 100. Now, unfortunately, there are no factors of negative 100 that add to positive 4, which means to solve for x, we'll have to use the quadratic formula. When using the quadratic formula, we do need to remember that a is going to be equal to positive 1, b is equal to positive 4, and c is equal to negative 100. So here's the quadratic formula. So now we'll perform substitution for a, b, and c. So we'll have x equals negative b or negative 4 plus or minus the square root of b squared or 4 squared minus 4 times a, which is 1, times c, which is negative 100. And this is all divided by 2 times a, or 2 times 1. Now we'll begin to simplify. We'll have x equals negative 4 plus or minus, this is going to be 16 plus 400, so it's the square root of 416 divided by 2. Let's continue simplifying this on the next slide. The next step is to simplify the square root of 416. I've already made a prime factorization tree over here on the right to save some time. So we'll have x equals negative 4 plus or minus the square root of 416. But the prime factorization of 416 has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 factors of 2 and a factor of 13. This is still divided by 2. So every time we have two equal factors, we have a perfect square factor. So this will simplify. This will simplify. So we have x equals negative 4 plus or minus, this is going to be 4 square root 26 all divided by 2. Let's break this up into two fractions. We have negative 4 divided by 2 plus or minus 4 square root 26 divided by 2. So we have x equals negative 2 plus or minus, this will be 2 square root 26. But we're still not done. If we go back to the original equation, notice how the value of x has to be greater than 0. And this represents two solutions. One solution is x equals negative 2 plus 2 square root 26. And the other solution is x equals negative 2 minus 2 square root 26. This value here is definitely going to be negative. So this is not a solution to the log equation. This is the exact solution to our log equation, But let's also find the decimal approximation. So we'll enter this into the calculator. We have negative 2 plus 2 square root 26 . So the decimal approximation for x is 8.1980. So depending on whether you're asked to find the exact solution or the solution rounded to 4 decimal places will affect how you give your answer. I hope you found this helpful.